Now joined by the head coach of the Mustangs, Coach Kathy Raley. Coach, there appeared to be a really big moment late in the first half where you made a change at the draw control and you went to Jamie Bittner. Mm-hmm. And it seemed like it really kind of changed everything about this game.
Well, I got to give credit to Kirsten McClellan, who is our draw coach. She was seeing that Carly was, even though Carly might be winning it her direction or winning it to sort of her side, she was not having an eye on it and being able to pick it up. So she made the change for Jamie to go there, and it actually really helped because Jamie reacts and boxes out a whole lot better than Carly does from that taking the draw position. Jamie may not always win the draw, but she is so good at anticipating where it is and boxing out when necessary and moving to wherever it goes, whether we win or lose it in our direction. So that was a huge change. Yeah,
and you're going up.
Credit to Kirsten. She did a great job with that.
And you were going up against a team that had someone who won 100 draw controls already this season.
She may have also won 100 today because there were about 150 draw controls today.
It seemed that way.
It was draw control and shooting practice at Mustang Stadium today.
There were 38 goals scored tonight.
Mm-hmm.
This time last week, there were 15 goals scored tonight.
Right.
During that broadcast, Glenn and I talked a little bit about that. Your team was a little bit stagnant that night on the offense and not moving so well off ball.
Mm-hmm.
Totally different story tonight.
That's so good to hear from up top that you can see them moving. We just need to get that. We're to the point that we have kind of created some rules of what you do off the ball. I thought we made the effort tonight to move in the way we're supposed to. We just didn't go to the right places. We had great practices this weekend where we really were going to the right places. We knew when to fade. We knew when to go set a pick and pick and roll. Today, as you could see, I think we lost two or three possessions on missed shots because we had no one moving to X. So we just have a lot of people who are very excited, very game excited. I think in another week or so, I think our just overall creative attack is going to be really, really good. I think we made it over the hump. I really do.
Can we have that happen in the next 3 days?
I was going
to
say.
It needs to happen on Saturday.
Yeah.
It needs to happen on Saturday. And you know, it could. Like,
yes.
We had a practice, I think, Saturday or Sunday that I was so impressed. Our defense is pretty good. And we were scoring at will against our own defense in practice. I mean, time after time after time. Just from off-ball movement and creating things, creating opportunities for our teammates to get open by using us in picks and picking and rolling. So I think we're over the hump with understanding attack. We just need to execute for 60 minutes attack.
Great.
Yeah.
Well, since you brought it up, let's just get into it.
Yeah.
Pretty big one on Saturday.
Yes.
This is a team that has been a thorn in your guys' side for the last couple of years when you face Messiah.
Mm-hmm.
How confident do you feel about the way the girls are playing right now going into what we know is the biggest game of the regular season?
Well, I think we need two things to beat Messiah. Number one, we have to control the clock. Number two, I think we need our goalie to be on fire. They're going to take good shots. Mac is a great goalie. We need her to really be moving to the ball and anticipating when shots are going to be taken. You know, just we've been reviewing film at Messiah a lot, and I think that Messiah's strength comes between the 30s. They're very good at doubling and putting pressure on. I think that we're really good with the ball between the 30s. We've got a lot of defenders who have great stick work, who have great vision of the field. So I think it's going to be a battle between the 30s, if you ask me. Now, that's assuming that we have, you know, like a hot, we need a goalie that's going to make some saves. And I thought Mac really got it together at the end of the game. And, you know, it's good that we got to play everybody tonight. That's a great, great scenario that you can get every single kid on your roster in, you know, with 5 or 6 minutes left. Yeah.
Before we let you go, you brought up Hannah Tankers late tonight.
Sure.
How nice was it to see her get going here tonight?
You know, she's got such great vision on the field, and she's so, because of her height, she's so easy to see. I thought tonight she made hard cuts that really allowed our attackers to have vision of her stick, vision of her moving through. She also was one of the ones that really executed the pick and roll very, very well today. So that allowed her to be open. And my favorite part of the whole thing, because she's always worked hard, my favorite part is that she finished with great shots to the open net. So I'm super proud of her. I'm very happy. I hope she gets the scoring bug.
Yeah.
That would be nice. That would be nice. And you know, just to add another threat. So we're hoping that Messiah is now saying, you know what? We can't just watch Keely Bunce and Carly Bowes. Now we've got to watch this person and this person and this person and this person. And then we have a shot.
Congratulations on a big win tonight.
Thank you.
Go get them on Saturday. She's Coach Kathy Raley.